Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Keisha. I like to talk about planners and journals. Today I'm going to be showing you what I got in the second aesthete box from Cloth and Paper. And this is the only item that I have been waiting for. So I'm just going to show you the pocket planner that came with the aesthete box this quarter. I have been using a Filofax as a wallet for this year. It's been working out really awesome for me. My only gripe with the Filofax though was that when I had my cards in this slot over here, they were just kind of hanging about and they got really, disorganized. I tried to get an insert for the rings to put like credit cards in a little plastic slot. When I ordered it from Amazon, it actually ended up being a personal size, not a pocket size like the listing said. So I just kind of sort of gave up. When I saw that this was coming out, I held off because there are card slots in here. So I'm going to just open that up for you real quick. I am assuming you are a Cloth and Paper fan, which is why you have clicked on this video, but in case you don't know, this is their very first pocket planner ever. They don't sell this on the website currently as of now. I'm not sure if they will in the future, but this is their very first pocket planner, and I guess it's their very first white planner as well. So my first impressions are that this planner is super stiff. When I opened it, it came all stuffed with like, Was it styrofoam? Anyway, there was some foam in here to like keep the structure. This is a little bit wider than the Filofax pocket. You could see just a little bit. And the rings are bigger too. So I believe this is like a 1-inch ring in here in the Filofax. And then I think this is like a 1.5-inch in the pocket planner. Don't quote me, but that's just kind of what I think. And also, I really love like softer leathers. This is supposedly a leather planner. I can never really tell, but it just doesn't really feel like leather to me. It feels more like vinyl or like a PU leather or something like that. So it's, it is printed, but look how chunkity chunk it is. I feel like I don't have that much stuff in here, but we'll go ahead and open it up and I'll show you how I've set it up. So like I said, it's super stiff. I have never owned another Cloth and Paper planner before, so I don't know if that's just like the nature of them and then they over time start to soften up, but I feel like you're really gonna wanna work laying this guy flat, if it ever is going to lay flat at all. I really love that all of my cards now fit in this card slot over here, though. That is super, super nice for me. The thing about the card slots, though, is once I stuffed this, I don't think I'm ever going to be able to use this front pocket because it's so tight, and same with the back. So I'm just like really scared. This thing is so stiff. Other than that, I've just got all of my pocket inserts from the Cloth and Paper subscription box over the last couple of months. This pocket did come with the aesthete subscription. They gave you a little bit of stuff to get started in your pocket planner. They gave you this pocket and they gave you this journaling insert, which we'll get to. But just to walk you really quickly through how I have this set up. My first section here is my goals section, and I use the visual manifesto that came in a sub box. So it's just basically like all of your yearly goals written down and things like that. And there's a vision board, and there's a monthly admin. I think this was a separate subscription insert, but I have not used the monthly admin much. I used it in February and then didn't create a new one after that. There is a dashboard. The second tab has the weekly admin, which I haven't really gotten into. My other dashboard here. And then I have the Filofax, Wecon 2-page diary, which has been really nice for an on-the-go planner. So if I'm out and about and I need to write down an appointment, you know, I'm going to the doctor frequently since I have to check up on my pregnancy and stuff like that. And whenever I make a new appointment, I don't tend to have like my planner with me like at the moment, but I do have my wallet. So I will jot it on whatever, I'll jot my appointment down in my planner here, and then I'll just transfer all that information over to my other planners. But yeah, also I've been trying to keep this updated to make sure that I don't double book myself by accident. So I just take, I don't save these. This is like purely informational, functional. Everything that I do save is going to be in my main planner, and I just take the inserts out of this as soon as I'm done. So like I only have May through the end of the year in here right now, because April's pretty much over. Third tab has just kind of a bunch of random stuff. There's another dashboard. I put the starter journaling insert in here. I actually don't think I'm going to use this, but I just have it in here because, I don't know, why not? It doesn't take up too much room. And then a dashboard here, and then I'm pretty sure this is a Peanuts Planner Co. insert. I was inspired by Lindsay Scribbles to use this a couple years back, and it's a sort of a daily page. You go from 6 a.m. to 12, and you can have like a running checklist and like a notes section. So I printed these out so long ago. I love the paper that I used. I love the format of this insert, and if I ever wanted to use it, I've got it in here ready to go. I have a study session from I think it's Trendy & Co. on Etsy. I was studying for the CPA exam, and I am not anymore. I am just too busy of a mom right now to tackle it, but I do like the layout of this because you can track down your hours in your plan, so you don't have to necessarily use it for studying, but you can keep track of time with this insert, which is really cute. I haven't used it much lately though. And then back here I have some note pages from the Filofax inserts that just come with the Filofax when you buy it, the contact pages. I don't think I have anybody's contact information in there. And then section 6 is essentially like where I keep all my money. I have these zipper pockets that I just got off Amazon, and I like to cash budget, and this pocket is designated for eating out, and this pocket is designated for fun. So I am so broke. It's been a tough couple of months, not gonna lie, but you know, when I am able to stuff these with cash, I put the cash in here just to make sure that I don't overspend. And I have this little pocket that I put my little planner stickers in. I don't plan in this pocket, but I do like having my stickers in here, so I usually just pull out my stickers when I'm planning in something else. And then I have some stamps from Christmas. Boy, I really gotta make sure I use those, which reminds me, I need to send my friend a letter in the mail. And then I have this, what do you call these? Like, it's like a page, not really a page protector, but it just makes sure that all of your pages, the back page doesn't get ruined, because stuff can wobble around in here, and I like to keep that back here to keep it protected. And then way back here in the last pocket is your care instructions. So it just says how to take care of the leather. And this back pocket is super, super stiff too. So comes with a pen loop. There is no back pocket like there would be in the Filofax, but that's okay. I have plenty of other pockets to keep my receipts and things. I typically keep receipts in my Filofax back pocket. And there's only one slot snap closure in the front. And that is about it. I don't typically baby my planners, but I think I'm definitely gonna baby this one just because it is white and I do have a toddler, and you just never know. So I love that it came with this little pouch, and I like that the pouch is, I don't know, like designed this way, so you can just slip your planner in here as such and fold it over, and it's like, you know, you don't have to unzip anything. It's just, it's pretty easy to put in here and take out, and that is that. So tell me what you think. If you have any tips for me about cloth and paper planners, especially, you know, with the stiffness and stuff, I'd love to know what your tips are. But thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.